This is NWHC Radio, a podcaster radio show focusing on punk and hardcore from the Pacific Northwest.
You're listening to episode 5 of NWHC Radio. This is Chris Williams coming to you from sunny San Luis Obispo, California, where I've been since February, so almost a year now. But I'm doing this show to help spread the word of all the goodness in the Northwest and, stay connected as much as I can to the region that I love so much. Thank you for listening. If you listen to the other episodes, thanks for tuning in again for the fifth time. And extra special thank you to anybody who took the 5 seconds it takes to hit that 5-star button, or anyone that took the time to write a quick review. That stuff apparently helps make sure that the algorithm gets this out there. And then anyone who shared on social, use your social platforms to help spread the word. Thank you so much. It means the world to me. I really appreciate it. Today, we're covering a range of 1983 to present, mostly in the Seattle, Portland, Vancouver, I-5 corridor, but, we'll hit some Calgary, and we're even going to hit some Missoula, Montana, which we don't normally do, but this is an exception, and I'll get to why later. Before we kick things off, just want to make sure everyone saw and is aware that the lineup for Just Another Gig, Volume 4, was announced. It will be February 10th and 11th at Real Art in Tacoma. The lineup is pretty crazy. We've got Gridiron, Judiciary, Spy, Mind Force, Warn, Ozone, Simulacra, Restraining Order, Dead Body, Big Boy, Apex Predator, Ego Death, A Morning Star, Denial of Life, Insecure, Video Prick, and that's just the first announcement. There's more TBA. So get your tickets ASAP. If you're not worried about it selling out, still think about getting your tickets early, just because I know, for people that book these big shows, it's a lot of money that they invest in flying bands out and commit to making sure that their expenses are paid. And, when we purchase those pre-sale tickets, I guarantee you that it takes a lot of stress off of the minds of the people who do this. And you know what? If it helps at all ensure that this thing that we love to go to continues for years and years and years, that's worth it. So check it out. Speaking of Tacoma, we're going to send the first one down to Tacoma with Just Another Gig Vets. I think they've played every single one so far. Although I don't see them on the first announcement, maybe they'll be on the next one, or maybe they'll take this one off. But we're going to play a song from By All Means from the 3-song self-titled EP in 2021, Platinum Hit Records. The song's called None Forgiven. I believe this is digital only. I don't think there's a hard copy of this, but I may be wrong. It features guest vocals from Crystal from Initiate, and the song's a rager. By All Means, Tacoma Hardcore.
Turn around your mouth while you sit in the mud. Fuck you, Play the game you play. Pay the price you want to pay. Day by day. Say it with your chest. Last chance to fully defend. Now you're scared. The truth's coming out of the life you planned. Then begin the functions of another. Fucking talk like your older brother. You're not worth a fucking dime. And now you sleep in the bed you made.
That was Trip to the River by the band Long Knife out of Portland, Oregon. As is tradition for NWHC Radio, we started with two tracks of two current bands who are out there doing it right now. This was off of Long Knife's Curbstop Earth LP 2022 on Blackwater Records. This LP is fantastic from start to finish. If you haven't heard it, check it out. If you've only listened to it a few times, throw it on again because it's going to be a classic. This song specifically is just such an incredible kind of love song to hardcore and punk about finding, you know, solace in this place despite the chaos and brutality of the world. And they just do an awesome job of painting the picture of what this thing is that we love. Next song is going to stay in Portland. Another current band, actually, a band that I love and respect so much, who has so much important stuff to say. I think hardcore is, you know, the greatest music sonically ever created, but what really makes it special is when bands have something to say and they put it all on the line and they speak from the heart and they talk about important things and they either pour out their souls or, you know, share wisdom, inspire. When we go back to that Long Knife song, the energy that is in the room at shows is unbeatable. But when a band can also inspire you and make you think about things, you know, make you realize things about yourself and about the world, like that's untouchable. So this first song is from a band called Dying For It. They were originally from California, moved up to Portland. The song is off their 2018 LP, Born to Deny. The song's called Predator. As the name of the song indicates, this is a song about sexual assault, something that is still way too common an occurrence in our world and in our scene. And it's something we need to continue to talk about and confront and address. I think it's the kind of thing that really thrives in the shadows and the darkness, and we need to shine a spotlight on it. And this song, more acutely, is referential to the orange sexual predator who occupied the White House for 4 years. So this is Dying For It, the song Predator, off of their 2018 LP, Born to Deny, Safe Inside Records. Also, if you're from the Portland area, this band is playing January 13th with FOM, No Man and Grip. Check them out at Mano Oculta.
And when you're a star, they let you do it. You can do anything.
Whatever you want.
Grab them by the pussies.
Thank you.
After Dying For It, you heard Blue Monday's The Everything Festival off of their rewritten LP, 2005 Bridge 9 Records, Vancouver, BC Hardcore. This song features guest vocals from Sean, who sang in verse, and What Feeds the Fire. And Blue Monday, great band. I feel like they are super underrated and appreciated. I think there's still a lot of love for Blue Monday in the Northwest, particularly in Vancouver. But beyond that, I do think they don't get quite as much love and respect as I think they've earned. Underrated band. I love the combo of how hard it was with the melody, plus also being kind of gloomy. I don't know. It's just a really cool mix. It worked really well for them. After Blue Monday, you heard Cold Truths, No Rules off of the No Rules cassette EP. This was from 2014, D2C Records. Tacoma-based band. The singer Trevor runs Dead Air Radio, which I've mentioned on this show before, is a big inspiration for me starting this thing, is what Trevor does over on Dead Air Radio. And he recently had me on his show. We talked for a few hours about just all the great hardcore from the Northwest in 2022. And we missed some stuff, unfortunately, but I think the amount of stuff that we covered and still forgot stuff just shows how strong the Northwest is right now. Because there have been times where, you know, I could have listed the number of really good bands on both hands, but you know, the Northwest is really strong right now. There's a lot of stuff coming out of a lot of different cities in the Northwest, and it's a magical thing. But yeah, go check that episode. Check out Dead Air. Another thing about this band, if you've ever been to a Tacoma Rainiers game or Seattle Thunderbirds hockey game, and you heard Slapshot or Earth Crisis or Trapped Under Ice or any other hardcore, you can thank Avery from this band for that. He is, I don't know if he still is, but at least as of recently, as a couple years ago, was in charge of the music over there. So it was always fun to go there and hear some good stuff and watch some hockey fights. All right, we're going to turn the clock back a little bit on these next three. And for the first two, I'm gonna play some demo tracks from some legendary bands, and specifically tracks that featured their original singers. The first one, Brotherhood, before Ron Gardapi sang, rest in peace. Ron was a legend and certainly made Brotherhood as powerful as they were. But before he sang, John White was the original singer, and they did this demo. Sounds horrible, but it's fun to listen to, just to hear kind of the difference. Not that John sounds horrible on this, but the recording's really bad. Like, you can barely hear the drums. It's just the kind of sounds like it's just the guitar and vocals, but it's cool to hear the song, which later became No Tolerance, with Ron singing, with John singing. It's called Band Together in Ignorance and has different lyrics, and you know, but you'll definitely recognize the riffs. Feels a bit weird to play this before playing an actual Ron G Brotherhood song, which I haven't done on the show, but I will fix ASAP. But as you know, the intro is a Brotherhood song. But everyone's heard Brotherhood with Ron singing, and I think probably there's a lot of people who haven't heard this yet. So I don't know, it's just interesting to get that perspective and see the process and how the lyrics and the vibe changed. You know, even though the recording isn't best, it's an important part of the history of the Northwest and Northwest hardcore. You know, it's interesting to see the journey. And John is still around. You know, you'll still see him at shows in the Northwest, still a lover of hardcore, still vegan, I think. So, yeah. So the first one will be Brotherhood, Band Together in Ignorance, featuring John White off of the Caring Edge demo in 1988. And then the next song is going to be also from a Seattle classic. It's Undertow, before Pettibone sang, a guy named Joel sang, and they had a demo that came out in 1990. And this is actually holds up surprisingly well. Like, it's obviously not as good as they would later become, but it's still a pretty impressive demo for a bunch of teenagers, and sounds pretty solid for something from 1990 as well. So the song that I'm going to play is I've Changed. But first, Brotherhood, Band Together in Ignorance, Caring Edge demo, 1988. You are the ignorance crew. You can't see past someone's skin. My patient, right, thin. Your hearts and minds, you're not strong, that's why. You need to hold on. Listen, I know it's true. I'll never join you and your crew. We're not saying you can't change. Take time to rearrange. You're together. And hey, no friends. You won't let the light shine through. You're together. And hey, no friends. You are the ignorance crew. You're together. Hey, don't bet. You won't let the light shine through. You're together. Hey, don't bet. You are the ignorance crew. That was Whorehouse of Representatives with the song Stolen Land, which originally was featured on Aftermath Comp on Profane Existence. Came out in 1999. This is also on their discography, which came out in 2006. And I think it's available in double LP or double CD, maybe. I'm not sure about that. I looked it up on Discogs, but my notes are a little bit confusing. So Whorehouse was an incredible punk band from the 90s, played a lot of hardcore shows, and always were super intense live. And yeah, they put out a lot of songs. So like I said, double LP discography. So yeah, dig into their archives. And then before that, we had Brotherhood's Band Together in Igorots featuring John White off of the Carrying Edge demo in 1988. And then Undertow's I've Changed off of their demo with original singer Joel. Pettibone actually played bass on this, so he was their bass player, and then Joel left and he slid over, and then they grabbed Damien. All right, I tease this at the top. We're gonna really push the boundaries of Northwest here, because we're going to go all the way to Missoula, Montana. Like I said, I'm not going to make a habit out of this, because I don't know of one other Missoula band, past or present, although I'm sure there are. If you know about some that are cool, hit me up. But the reason I wanted to play this is because members of this band actually became pretty important figures in the Seattle scene. In the 90s, when grunge kind of blew up, a lot of those members were punk and hardcore kids. And this song is from a band from Missoula, Montana called Deranged Diction. And the song is called Kill or Be Killed off of the No Art, No Cowboys, No Rules LP. Came out originally in 1983 and then was a double CD on Feedback Records in 2009. Again, my notes from Discogs are a little bit sloppy here, so some of that may be off. But anyways, Deranged Diction featured Jeff Ament, who later went on to Pearl Jam, as you know, and then Bruce Fairweather, who played in Green River and Love Battery. So I don't know. It's just kind of cool to see how all this stuff fits together. I wasn't as plugged into the hardcore scene specifically during that whole grunge explosion. I'm sure there were hardcore kids that hated that stuff, but a lot of the key grunge players were in punk or even hardcore bands, you know, before their big bands. And then, as you know, Duff McKagan, who went on to Guns N' Roses, was also a crucial early 80s Seattle hardcore person. And I mean, grunge was a moniker that was kind of created by the media, as far as I can tell. You know, what the sound originally kind of came from was kids who really liked punk and kids who really liked Black Sabbath, and this is the sound that kind of emerged. But anyways, this song's called Kill or Be Killed by Deranged Diction, 1983, Missoula, Montana hardcore.
Are you ready? Kill me, kill! Are you ready? Kill me, kill!
That was the band Last Man Standing off of their second demo, which came out in 1998. The song, I have no idea what the song is called because I lost the liner notes, and everyone in the band that I messaged to try and find out the name of the song didn't know either. So that's a Last Man Standing song. Who knows what the song is called, but it's the best song they ever wrote, in my opinion. None of this is on Discogs, but yeah, it came out on a demo CD in 1998. And Last Man Standing was a Seattle and Federal Way band. So long before Apex Predator was Last Man Standing. So if you want to know about the roots of Federal Way hardcore, I don't know, there's probably other Federal Way hardcore bands before Last Man Standing. But if you like Apex Predator, you probably would have liked Last Man Standing because they're fun. They were hard. Had lots of good breakdowns. Members went on to a ton of other bands, including Stay Gold, Pistols at Dusk, Entropy Project, Hardesty, which I played in episode 3, and a ton of other things. Ahead of that, we played Devil in Disguise by the band Endgame out of Calgary, Alberta. This is a single that they dropped this year, featuring Kat from Scowl. Finally got to see this band at Scoped Exposure Showcase in Calgary. Spencer from this band does Scoped Exposure podcast and video stuff, so check them out if you haven't. It's another great hardcore podcast. But yeah, they were sick live, really good. And Kat sounds amazing on this as well. So I'm excited to, this is a great song. The demo or EP or whatever they did before this was really good as well. So excited to hear some more stuff from them. Hopefully we get it soon. We're going to do two more tracks and then shut it down until episode 6, which I already have a whole slate of good stuff lined up for. But the first one I'm going to play is a band from 2007 called Vanguard. It's featured members of The Answer, Gone But Not Forgotten, Clarity, Growing Stronger, Gravemaker, a lot of people that are still involved in the hardcore to this day. Really cool band. Last time I got to see them was a Rainfest pre-show that they did with Sinking Ships and who else played? Barricade, maybe. All those all kind of run together, but it was a good time. And yeah, Vanguard was always awesome. The song is called 1 in 5 from The Calm CD LP 2007, Endwill Records. You may recognize the name. Also did some records for The Shook Ones, The Answer, Where Eagles Dare, The Disaster. So cool label of the time. A lot of good stuff. Go back and check them out. 1 in 5, Vanguard, Seattle Hardcore 2007. That was The Bed You Made by the band Guard Dog off of their Demo 16, which came out, you guessed it, 2016. Phaser Records did a cassette version of this. This is a Seattle / Olympia, I guess, band. Speaking of Apex Predator, Casey and Joey from Apex played in this band. Joey sang. Waylon from Lower Species was also in this band. Oddman Out, Military Gun, and then Ryan from Nasty and Advertisement and Vacant Life. Waylon also played an Advertisement. So yeah, just a bunch of Seattle area vets. And this band ruled. This demo was so sick. I think they only played maybe 4 or 5 shows. I recorded one of them at the Nut Hole. It's up on YouTube. Go check it out. You can find it pretty easily. Just search Guard Dog Nut Hole. Hopefully you'll get some safer work results on that search. But Yeah, cool band. The Bed You Made is the name of that track. I don't know. Joey was a really sick vocalist, both in this and White Wards, but this was a little bit more my lane. I just loved the kind of like, I don't know, war zone slash locking out style beats. And they were sick live. That's it for episode 5. Look for episode 6 to drop in about 2 or 3 weeks, probably. Until then, there's some good shows coming up in the Northwest. January 4th in Seattle, we got Mexican Coke. January 7th in Seattle, Lilith and the End of Days and some others. January 8th, Wake of Humanity is playing Portland. I won't list all the bands' names for all these because I talked about a few of them on the last episode, but check these all out. They're sick lineups, and there are a lot of other really good bands on this too. January 13th through 15th, FOM and No Man are coming to the Northwest, so look for dates throughout the Northwest there. And then January 17th through 20th, Bib and Candy are doing a run through the Northwest. February 2nd through 4th, we got Military Gun doing a Northwest run. February 10th through 11th, I mentioned this at the top, but Jag V4, just another gig. Get your tickets now. And then Botch is playing some shows in Tacoma on the 17th and 24th and 25th of February. March, we got Tsunami and Ingrown in the Northwest. I don't know, just check out, if you're on Twitter, follow PNW Hardcore. If you're on Instagram, follow Brainstem Productions, and you can learn about a lot of these. Before I go, it's the end of 2022, and it's the time of year where everyone talks about their favorite releases of the year, and I'm going to do that. I'm going to run through some of my favorites. Some of them are Northwest related, some aren't, but that's okay because these bands will come to the Northwest, and some of them have ties and some of them don't. So yeah, let's run through them. So my top 10 records of 2022, any genre, most of these are going to be hardcore, but any genre. Number 10, I'm going to start off with Australia's Peace Ritual, self-titled EP. This is not hardcore, but this is just incredible, beautiful music. If you like dream pop or early aughts emo, you may dig this. Some of it reminds me maybe a little bit of Jimmy Eat World. The singer of this band actually was in a band with Jem from Speed before this, so can't remember the name of that band, but check this out. It's really good. I really like it. Number 9, Baltimore's Praise, All in a Dream on Revelation Records. If you've checked this out and weren't feeling it, give it a few more listens because this is a grower for sure. It's great. Number 8 is LA's Sweat, who was just up in the Northwest a month or so ago. This LP, gotta give it up. Fans of Power will probably dig this a lot. You know, a lot of mid-tempo hardcore with plenty of kind of sleazy rock and roll riffage. 7. This is a French band, but and the name is in French. I'm not even going to try to butcher it, but the translation is Prisoner of Time. And the translation of the name of the record is Like a Caged Lion. This is total boot music, but with a heavy dose of moody goth. So I think Criminal Damage is drenched in Joy Division. This is the bass player of Syndrome 81, which, spoiler alert, I'm going to talk more on them in a second. Number 6, I have Exide from North Carolina with Deliberate Revolver. New Morality Zine put this out. Nick from NMZ is based in Chicago, but went to school in Seattle and was heavily involved in the scene here. So he gets the PNW pass. This record's crazy good, though. It's like somewhere between Quicksand, Snapcase, Cast Iron Hike, and Sunny Day Real Estate. And that sounds like a crazy mix, but it works well for them. Number 5, High Viz out of London, the LP Blending. This is on everyone's lists for good reason, but it's real good. Number 4, this is a Northwest band, Punitive Damage. This is the Blackout. It's the only Northwest release in my top 10, but that's only because there were 9 amazing records that are just that undeniable, or I'd have more NW stuff. There's a ton of easy candidates that would be in my top 10 and are just outside of it. If you want a list of those, just look at my playlists of the first 5 episodes, and obviously I'm playing the stuff that I love the most. So anything you see on my list from 2022, you can bet that that's in my top, 20 or so. The Long Knife record is a fantastic example. That's probably like number 11 for me. But yeah, Punitive Damage record is in freaking incredible. Number 3, Inclinations, Unaltered Perspective. This is a mastercrafted record. I reviewed this for ineffecthardcore.com a few weeks back, so go read that if you want to learn more about it. My favorite hardcore release of 2022 is from The Bay, Field of Flames, Consequences of War Against Us. This is like a modern take on Strife and Eyelid, who Eyelid, in my opinion, is criminally underrated 90s band. But yeah, this is fantastic. And then my favorite record of 2022 is more of an Oi record. Again, this is from France. Syndrome 81, Imaginary Prisons is the translation of the title of this record. It's got that heavy French Oi vibe with plenty of melodies, but the production makes it stand out. The guitar tones, especially the leads, are so clean. It almost sounds like The Cure at times. But the drum beat keeps that kind of like driving rock steady vibe that keeps us firmly in the boot territory. So if you haven't heard it, check it out. Even if you don't like Oi, you may be surprised by this one. It is unbelievable. That's it for episode 5. Thank you for indulging me in my little list of favorite records of this year. And we'll be back again, like I said, in a few weeks, 2 or 3 weeks, with episode 6. Got an awesome playlist that I'm really psyched for that one. So until then, follow us at NWHC Radio on Instagram and Twitter and say what's up. Thank you for checking us out and thank you for supporting Northwest Hardcore.